Welcome back to the Southampton International Boat Show 2021. Now the boat behind me is something that actually makes my heart beat a little bit faster, and that is the Rustler 42. Now these boats have huge pedigree, owned by members of the royal family, but they are also like achingly beautiful both outside and inside. This to me, it's the prettiest boat in the show. So can I be objective? I'm going to try to be. Classic design. This hasn't changed in 19 years. We're talking an encapsulated keel, which is an absolute rarity in the days of bolt-on keels. Cutter rigged, deep safe cockpit, like woodwork to absolutely die for. Let's go inside and see what we think about her. So here I am in the cockpit of the Rustler 42. Now, as you know, when I was on Ruby Rose, I absolutely adore, I love teak work. And this is, there's teak work abound here. Full cockpit sole in teak. There are the benches in teak, but also all the kind of like the surrounds for both the hull and the cockpit, all in teak. Absolutely love it. It's a bespoke build, so like the best quality in everywhere, just from the quality of the stainless steel, quality of the teak work, like massive oversized winches, probably for a 42 foot boat, compared to the fact we were on a 38 foot boat. These winches are substantially larger. So huge, deep, safe cockpit, single wheel. Would I feel comfortable in here? Absolutely. So other notes, obviously she's tapered at the stern. Centrally mounted self-steer and a Watt and Sea generator. So you're gonna have all your power requirements totally handled underway. When we were generating 7 knots mid-ocean, the Watt and Sea 300 will knock out about 20 amps. So again, from a power management point of view, this is probably pretty self-sufficient. So single wheel, we've got bow thruster control, compass, plotter. Central traveler, so again you can adjust the traveler completely from the cockpit, and then moving forward you have this semi-hard dodger, so screen. So again, this is going to be pretty useful you know, when in inclement weather. Also oversized spray hood. I'm not sure if this is a custom option, but again, there's a lot of protection here if you're trying to keep yourself safe and out of the weather. Outside exterior deck, there's no teak here, which I actually really love. It's a real nod to the fact that obviously the owners understand that teak is not always a good thing. Really wide side decks. This boat is carbon rigged, cutter rigged as well. So we've got like a really lovely sailing plan. I have such a crush on this boat. It is insane. Like, I really do love it. It's just, it's well built. And honestly, yeah, I have to talk to Terysa about this.
And then finally, as we move forward, there is a large sail locker. You'll be able to get lots of sails, fenders in here, and your line stowage. And again, everything absolutely immaculate quality. Anchor, capstan, capstan itself, and then you move forward to the bowsprit. Little dolphin watching seat there. Absolutely beautiful boat. Now let's take you through some statistics. The sail areas, the main sail is 440 square foot, Yankee 536, the Genoa 670, and that little staysail 179 square foot, cutter rigged with an optional carbon rig. As for the dimensions, we are looking at an LOA of 42 feet, beam 13.4, 6'2" draft and 10,300 pounds of ballast gives her a displacement of 26,000 pounds. She is a medium displacement yacht. And the total price of this yacht, well, with the carbon rig, this particular model is around the $1 million US mark, but you do get one of the most beautiful boats in the world for your money. The attention to detail everywhere is evident from this boarding ladder, which folds up so neatly into the side decks. Teak work that is so well finished, just every small little detail. Absolutely fantastic. I really, really do adore this yacht. And while your eyes dance wistfully over this teak covered beauty, just a quick moment to take to introduce you to our Patreon account. Feel free to have a look. We've got lots of amazing extra content there. Now let's take a dive down into the interior of the Rustler 42.
All right, what can I say? Wow. I love boats like this. Like, I absolutely love boats like this. We are talking a fully customizable interior. This looks like oak to me. Let's start with the chart table. So half-size chart table, plotter instruments, huge, huge instrument panel. So everything controllable. Genset control there. We have a stereo, VHF radio, other controls there. There's also heating on board. So maybe they're going for high latitude sailing. Again, we have port lights. They don't open, but there's a lot of light in here. There's a lot of light. Again, one opening hatch up in the ceiling and recessed lighting. Moving forward to the saloon area, we have a large U-shaped settee on port, and then another kind of like longer settee, which probably converts into a sea berth on starboard. There's also seating here, and I believe that under here there is plant machinery. Galley, we have an L-shaped galley, and again, everything is absolutely, like, it's bespoke. The quality of this woodwork is absolutely divine. And again, you can see little touches like this, dedicated plate storage. All beautiful. Even actually the sound of that, you know, you can tell that is just beautifully solid wood. Interior fans, lights. And then we've got four sets, foot operated. Again, this is a real sailor's boat. So that will be tap water. One of them will be drinking water. Then will be a saltwater spigot. So again, water saving at sea. Absolutely phenomenal. Really lovely. Really, really lovely. And now let's move forward into the master cabin. So again, in here we have, would we call it a full size double? Just about, I think probably at that end, it's slightly narrower than I would want it. So when we had a V berth in our previous boat, we used to sleep actually, you know, with our feet to the bows. So again, full size wardrobe there, just storage beneath. It's all immaculate. I mean, all I would say is that if I had to judge the quality of build here, this is superior to Southerly. I can see that, you know, little things like this, like literally, from my point of view, like little nerdy things, like you've got literally the doweling that holds this kind of fiddle in place is like perfectly flush, well sanded, finish is fantastic. And even here, and these are just slightly nerdy points, this fiddle is sculpted. So there's a little groove. So it's not completely smooth, lovely handhold there. And again, yeah, the quality of this entire finish, absolutely phenomenal. Really, really happy with this. So moving around again, storage for books. It's a lovely living area. I think the best way I can describe this, it's very, very boaty. Very boaty, love it. And a traditional design. So we're looking at traditional hull shape. This design hasn't changed in 19 years. So you have some really traditional features, very well built boat. Again, would I sail around the world in this? In a heartbeat. I love it. Just love it. Absolutely love the boat. So moving aft, let's go into the aft heads. So we have actually a really lovely sized heads there. Something that we always wanted in Ruby Rose. We wanted a shower screen. So there's a shower screen there. Heads there. And then there is plant machinery in here. So we have water maker, high capacity water maker, the holding tank for the heads. Then we've got the little sober washing machine, the 3 kilo washing machine. And again, just so we are now moving down the companionway steps and into the aft cabin. Now again, this is a coffin berth, but nonetheless, there is probably a good double in here. There is one opening hatch. Again, quality of the woodwork, absolutely phenomenal. Functional drawers. Really lovely. I mean, look, again, good quality catches. This really is a boat of probably my dreams, actually. Absolutely love this.
and with a little assistance from the very kind chaps at Rustler, you can access the engine bay. You have to pull a lever underneath the galley to remove the top box, and then everything kind of like falls into place. Now, the advantage of having the engine here is that you have it centrally mounted. That's great for weight distribution, and you have a good shaft drive. Different engine options here. This one is specified with a large Yanmar.
So what do we think, Rustler 42? What did you think? Let us know in the comments down below whether this kind of like ticks the boxes for you or not. What do I think? Firstly, the entire shape, the shape of the bow, the shape of the profiles. These are not plumb bows. This boat will cut through the water super well. She'll cut into that groove super sea kindly. You know, the Rustler 36 has got huge pedigree. The Rustler 42, an amazing boat. Cutter rigged, everything over engineered. She is a strong boat, and down below, absolutely, you know, woodwork to die for. If that is the sort of thing that you're into, I really do like the kind of woody boats, especially in these classic yachts. So do I like it? Absolutely love it. Would I own one of these boats for circumnavigation? Absolutely, I think she's fantastic. I do, I love Rustlers. What don't I like about it? Nothing really, but let me just pull this apart and nitpick a little bit. Number one, she's tapered at the stern. Now that tapering will give you an amazing downwind motion. She's not going to wallow around like Ruby Rose did with her fat ass. So that's the first thing, but that means that you're going to lose some internal volume. And that means that if volume and kind of a liveaboard boat is what you want, and you kind of want those big spacious aft cabins, then this is going to fall a little short of the mark. So that's the first thing. Second thing, not everyone likes those encapsulated keels. I personally love them because that wine glass hull profile means that she is going to sit so well in the water. The other thing about this boat is that, and we actually have had this from first-hand experience because we have friends that had a Rustler 42. At anchor, it is not as easy to get into the dinghy and back on to the boat from a dinghy because of the way the transom is. So although there can be transom steps and a transom ladder, there's no bathing platform, there are no steps down. There are more difficulties in kind of getting on and off the boat. Now, as a circumnavigator, if I wanted to circumnavigate and I had the money, would I buy this boat? Absolutely. It probably would be my number one choice. I do absolutely love this boat. If I wanted to spend time dossing around the Bahamas, would I buy this boat? No, I don't think it's the ideal boat for that. But for long, safe, fast offshore passages, this is going to be hard to beat. So that is our look at the Rustler 42. Would I buy it? Absolutely. So I hope you enjoyed this. It's just, again, a continuation of this series in how we look at monohulls, what we looked for in monohulls, and what we continue to look at as the market kind of evolves and develops. And this is really nice to see that they are not kind of embracing all these newfangled designs and going, actually, we've got something that works, and it works really well. So hope you enjoyed this. Give us a like, give us a thumbs up. And if you haven't already done so, subscribe down there, because we'll be back kind of soon with lots more review videos. So enjoy that. Goodbye.
And if you haven't already done so, feel free to subscribe. We have an in-depth look at the Halberg Rassies and the Moody Deck Saloons next in the series.